In this video, we will introduce a parameter that is often used to characterize the recombination in a solar cell, J0. We know this parameter as the saturation current density in the ideal diode equation or the Shockley equation, and here we will look at another interpretation. The learning objectives are to first understand the relation between the open circuit voltage of a solar cell, VOC, and J0, and how this is related to the carrier lifetime. We then will define a relation between the recombination rate and J0. Now let us first take a look at this band diagram of a PN junction, a solar cell. When this device is illuminated and when no external current is flowing, a voltage bias develops across the device equal to the VOC. The quasi-Fermi levels, EFN and EFP, are horizontal and express the charge carrier density in this static or steady state situation. The current voltage relationship for an illuminated solar cell is given by this expression. When we evaluate this expression for the applied voltage equal to the VOC and at which the external current density is zero, and subsequently rearrange it, we find the following equation for the VOC. In this equation, JPH is the photogenerated current density. This photogenerated current density is often approximated by the short circuit current density JSC, and as JSC is much larger than J0, we find the following relationship for the VOC. The important conclusion is that the VOC is related to the saturation current density J0. Now we return to the band diagram and examine the VOC in a different way. This time, we work out the minority carrier densities in the P and N-type region and express these using the energy differences between the quasi-Fermi levels and the intrinsic Fermi level. We then find that the product of the minority carrier concentration in each region is equal to the intrinsic carrier concentration squared times an exponential factor containing the VOC. This relationship looks a bit like the mass action law, but then applied to a steady state non-thermal equilibrium situation. If we apply the ambipolar transport equation to the regions outside the space charge region, then we find that the steady state carrier concentration equals the generation GL times the carrier lifetime tau naught. Combining the two equations gives an expression for the VOC, and we now see that the VOC is directly related to the lifetime that characterizes the recombination. That can be easily seen for Shockley retall or SRH recombination, for which the lifetime is inversely proportional to the defect density. In that case, we can clearly see that the defect density affects the VOC directly. We have seen before that the total lifetime depends on several recombination mechanisms acting at the same time: radiative recombination, Auger recombination, and Shockley retall or SRH recombination. On top of these mechanisms, recombination at the surface adds another opportunity. We now consider a P-type semiconductor with thickness W and look at the total recombination throughout the material. We've seen before that the recombination rate Rn is determined by the excess minority carrier concentration and the lifetime. The total recombination rate is then obtained by integrating Rn over the thickness of the wafer, and we find this expression. This expresses the recombination rate in steady state equilibrium, which is not the same as thermal equilibrium. For the parameter J0, we look at thermal equilibrium. In that case, we have seen that the generation rate equals the recombination rate. In fact, we can take this further and state that based on the principle of detailed balance, the rate for each recombination mechanism is equal to an associated generation rate. It is important to realize that this is the case for thermal equilibrium. In steady state equilibrium, the generation rate and recombination rate may be spatially different. Before we move to J0, we first look again at the recombination rates for each mechanism, but then for thermal equilibrium. In that case, we see that for radiative recombination, the rate simply depends on the thermal equilibrium carrier concentrations. We can extend this easily to the other recombination mechanisms. In order to obtain J0, we multiply the recombination rate by the elementary charge and integrate it over the thickness of the semiconductor wafer to arrive at this expression. Applying this procedure in the same way for the other mechanisms, we find for each mechanism an associated J0. Now we'll briefly point out how the concept of J0 is applied to a solar cell, and for that we look at this cross-section. Anywhere in the solar cell, the recombination processes are active, but we can pinpoint several places with an associated J0, like radiative recombination in the bulk of the device, together with SRH recombination and Auger recombination. The J0 associated with surface recombination evidently only acts at the surface. The total J0 is simply the sum of all components. This in turn can then be related directly to the VOC of the solar cell. Summarizing, we have seen that the VOC is related to J0 and, likewise, that the VOC is related to the carrier lifetime. The latter implies a direct connection between the VOC and the recombination in the device. To characterize this relationship, we have expressed the total recombination of each process in an associated J0, which can then be used to estimate the VOC.